Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to Let's Play Fallout 4. I'm your host, Dude Long Couch. We are at ArcJet Systems, and we're about to roll deep in this motherfucking place. Let's talk to Paladin Dance first.
Dance, listen up. We do this clean and quiet. No heroics and by the book. Understood?
What book? Okay, why are we at ArcJet again?
Why are we at ArcJet again? We're here to retrieve a device that will boost the signal from the radio tower at the Cambridge Police Station. Without it, we can't make contact with our superiors. Remember, our primary target is the deep range transmitter. Stay focused and check your fire. I don't want to be hit by stray bullets.
I've definitely never shot a companion before. You don't even have to worry about that, bro. Okay, deep range transmitter. I'm on it. We've got this guy and we've got Piper here. I'm decked out. We should be good. Sorry, did you say something? I was looting the pack of cigarettes over there. 10mm pistols just laying around. Hold on. There's a terminal in there. Can I get in there from over here? No, looks like we gotta come in from the other side. Here's as though what?
Excuse me, Paladin Dance. Look at these wrecks. It appears as though the facility's automated security's already been dealt with.
Well, thank the Lord for that.
Good. Less security to worry about. Negative. There's nothing good about it. Look at the evidence. There isn't a single spent ammunition casing or drop of blood in sight. These robots were assaulted by Institute synths.
Ooh. Yeah, it is the same as a robot. That's why I keep calling them that.
Synth, isn't that the same as robot? They're an abuse of technology created by the Institute. Abominations meant to improve upon humanity. It's unacceptable. They simply can't be allowed to exist.
Well, shit. I guess it's a good thing I didn't come here with Nick, because I don't know if they could get along.
I'll be on the lookout. Roger that. Let's move out.
Shit, I should have asked him if he knew more about the Institute. I don't know why I didn't do that. I can't help but notice that I've been looting a lot of desk fans lately. I probably have like 7 of them in my inventory.
This place is a mess, but I still see a few pieces of steel.
Alright, let's see what's in here. Security concerns. From Tom Reithart. I'd like to have your team get together and implement a new security strategy for the ArcJet complex. This is our first contract for the USSA, and I don't intend to have any security slip-ups. While we're working on the XMB booster engine, I want you to double the coverage 24 hours a day and install automated countermeasures inside the facility. I'd also like you to hire a consultant to figure out a better security password for our terminals. The automated reset timer mailing out passwords is ridiculous. Yeah, that doesn't sound super secure to me. On the subject of turrets, starting tomorrow, we'll begin distributing identification badges to all employees. These badges must be worn at all times. They are infused with a low-yield radioactive isotope that will prevent our internal security turrets from accidentally shooting any of our own employees. If anyone is caught near the entrance to the engine core without a badge, we are not liable for the injuries you may sustain. The turrets will go online in 1 week, so I suggest you sign up for your badge as soon as possible. That's cold. So if we could find one of those, what were they called again? Just an ID badge. If we could find an ArcJet ID badge, that would definitely save us from any turrets that may be left. Let's see. Sam, what the hell's going on down there? How did a member of the press get all the way past security, through the entire research facility, and into the engine core without tripping our alarms or turrets? We have a real mess on our hands, and it's going to be your job to clean it up. I don't care how you do it, just make it all go away. If this comes back to bite us, I swear you're going to be the one that takes the fall. Rude. And protection. Protectron control. Protectron unit absent or damaged. Alright, well, I guess we can't activate him then.
What'd they use you for, junk?
I was gonna say, I'm sad that I can't salvage anything from any of this stuff. It seems like there should be some really high-tech stuff to take in there. Good news is, I can loot the janitor's closet, so at least I got that going for me. helmet on. Hmm. Thought there might have been a door leading back into that terminal that we could see from when we came in. Guess we probably have to wrap around farther to get to that, though. Gonna do what to the area? Didn't quite catch that. Alright, well there's obviously a terminal right there that we're gonna use to get it open. I'll look around first. Lab analyst terminal. Reminder, password security. This is your annual reminder that all terminal and mainframe passwords are to be changed on a monthly basis. Failure to do so may result in automated changes, the suspension of network privileges, and or disciplinary action. Please do your part in keeping ArcJet system secure. You can definitely set expiration dates on passwords. It should not be incumbent upon the employee to do that himself. That's stupid. Hey, we found the password! According to our records, your terminal password has not been changed in 3 months. For security purposes, your password will now be reset. And we're gonna send it to you in clear text, type, so... We are really not all that concerned with security, we're just acting like we are. But in reality, we're fucking idiots. What's that? Okay. That's what we got here. Oh, hold on. Discarded ArcJet work log.
Why the heck are they making us record this? Oh crap, it's on, isn't it? this is Technician Rand, ArcJet Propulsion Division. I'm here with Technician Janowski, work log A1190. Janowski and I have been working on the Mars Shot project for about 3 months now, and I think we have the thrust calculations worked out.
Man, I wish I was headed up there with those guys. Be nice to get the hell away from our lousy planet.
Hey, easy. If we don't record these logs properly, we're gonna get fired. The supervisor is already itching to get rid of us, especially since it's taking us longer than we promised.
So what? We've been drafted anyway. We're shipping out in a few weeks, remember? Soon we'll be doing push-ups, eating freeze-dried rations, and just wishing we were spending our day inside a cushy private laboratory.
Of course I remember. But I'm trying not to imagine getting my head blown off when I'm on the front line, and keeping my mind on work is helping me deal with the problem. Maybe that doesn't make sense to you, but it's important to me, okay?
All right. I'm sorry. Look, why don't you toss this tape, and we'll start a new one.
That was kind of funny. All right, let's get in here. Lab controls. Accessing prototype interlink. Unable to establish a connection to the prototype. Aww. I really wanted to establish a connection to the prototype, guys.
Nice work. Let's get
to it. Oh boy. Hey, that went pretty damn okay. Certainly a lot better than the first time I fought these fuckers.
Hello?
Hello? That also reminds me, I never really used my shock baton.
Appears to be nothing. Perhaps my sensors need calibration.
Can you do sneak attacks in the power armor? Seems counterintuitive. Oh, Billy! What the fuck? Dude, I can't even get in there. guys? Can I? Alright. I'll tell you what, Dance, you just handle everything. You're good. You're doing a great job. I'll just be out here. I'm not even sure what blew up over here. Must have been a landmine or something. Alright, can I get in here now? This definitely seems like the right weapon to be using, though, because they're totally, like, refilling my ammo, which is great. Ugh. It's so annoying when you get, like, right to the end, and then it's just like, nope! Not quite good enough.
Got it.
Yay. So all I gotta do is make sure that Piper's there whenever I want to pick a lock. And eventually, she will love me. Guess I'm going up the back way here.
Damn synths have compromised most of the facility.
Ooh. I gotta be honest with you guys. Every now and then, I feel a little self-conscious that I spend so much time in this Let's Play looting stuff. But then I realize that's just what Fallout is. Honestly, if you don't want to watch people be looting things, you're not watching the right series. Alright, we've got some workbenches up here. It's kind of cool. While I'm here... Short hunting rifle. That's new. I think. Can't do that in that's so stupid. Why would I not be able to do that? If I can handle weaponry and other things when I'm in power armor, I should be able to do this kind of stuff. Just thinking from like a logical perspective. What else did I pick up? I thought I picked up another weapon that I didn't want at some point. Maybe it was this. That does 44 damage. And... Wow, that does more than the damn sniper rifle does. Yeah, I probably should hold on to that. See if I can turn it into a sniper somehow. I wonder what, like, qualifies it as a sniper rifle. Is it the scope? If I look at this... Wait. This is a hardened pipe revolver sniper rifle. Has a hardened receiver, a long light barrel. Is it just the long light barrel that does it? This looks more like a shotgun when you actually look at it, but it's called a rifle. So if I put a long light barrel on here, superior range and sighted accuracy, better recoil. And now it is called... Now it's just a regular hunting rifle. But it's... Still probably better. So I should put like a really good scope on here. Alright, first of all, let's do the receiver. Because that'll make it do even more damage. Stock has to be short. Medium magazine. Reduces reload speed, but gives more ammo. I'm okay with that on a rifle. And... Shit, I can't put any other scope on it. I thought I could do a medium scope, but I must have used something that I needed. That adhesive. That sucks. And we could put a bayonet on here, but that reduces the range. Again, not a great thing to put on a rifle. Alright, I'll probably keep that around for a little while at least. Was that the whole point of coming up here, was just... getting access to this stuff?
Well, if anyone could figure out a good use for it...
That looks so cool every time you step into that. It's really satisfying for some reason. Come on. Okay. Oh.
There's a story here. We'll find it.
Hold up. Can you VATS that? You cannot VATS the laser tripwires. All right, that's good to know. Oh boy. Are you done? Okay. I didn't know if that thing was gonna blow up or just sit there and crackle like that. It's weird that I can't loot those either. In a lot of games, when you come across a trap like that, or a mine or whatever, you know, if you see it ahead of time, you can then loot it. Take it for yourself, or at least loot parts from it. This game, you can loot everything else in the world, but you can't loot the things that you saw ahead of time, you know, skillfully. Yeah, whatever.
That's it.
Gold-plated fliplighter. I already found one of those before, but I'll take that one too. Alright, so we do have a chem station here. Let me, grab this first. Another expert level lock. Jesus. Yay, got it.
Yes.
Oh, yeah. Sensor module. Look at that circuitry. And copper. I think those are both kind of, rare. That's a good safe. And we reached level 12. All right. I can't do expert terminals, can I?
Security's too tight.
Piper, are you good at that stuff? Oh, shit. No. I was trying to hold down A on her to command her to do stuff, and I came out of the armor. Can I not do that when I'm in the armor? Piper, stand still. Stay right there. Fucking... Alright, we'll just do it outside the armor.
Heads up.
Where to?
No way I'm cracking this.
Alright. I don't know if it's...
Security's too good.
No, I want her to do it.
Over here.
Uh-huh.
There we go. That work?
I don't think I can get to that.
Cause you... Ugh.
Move here.
Can do.
Hacking this is beyond me.
Out of my reach. Don't see a way for me to get there.
Idiot can't walk around my power armor. Okay, I don't think she can do those anyway. Just have to leave him be. And while we're up here, let's craft a bunch of shit. I can't do it in the power. Okay. The other way. I need this. Drugs. I need drugs, guys. The buff jet. Slow time. Max health. Plus 5 intelligence and highlights living targets for 8 minutes. That's pretty cool. All this stuff seems useful for different things. Alright, we're gonna make a bunch of this. And we'll make some of this. That's all my buff out. Great mentats. Oh, that's plus 5 charisma. I should have made some of that. Jeez. Too bad I used all my mentats. And we can do some of this. Slow time. This stuff all seems to have like really random effects, but it's all useful. Sadly, I cannot make any grenades because they all require adhesive and oil and fertilizer and... I don't have any of that stuff. Glowing blood pack. Plus 75 rad resistance for 10 minutes. That's pretty cool. Refreshing beverage. Removes all rads and cures addictions. I don't have any addictions. We can make our own stim packs, though. With blood packs, antiseptic, and steel. Really? I guess because it's a stim pack. That makes sense. Yeah, let's make all these. As much as we can. And blood packs are required for these. Oh, that's fine. Mines, syringer, utility. Alright, that's about all we can make for now. And lastly, we've got to figure out where we're going to spend our points. Okay. I think last time we upgraded our charisma. Probably don't need to do that again. At least not right now. Demolition expert? I don't use explosives a ton. Well, that probably would improve my grenades. I think I said I was gonna get the rifle perk last time. And since I just made a pretty decent rifle gun, and I have a sniper and everything now, maybe that would be a good idea. Access to base level and rank 1 armor mods. Oh, so we don't even have access to base level right now. That's why it's never let me do any armor shit. Man. That's really annoying. How much the amount of time I've wasted trying to do that shit, when the game could have just told me in the text, hey, you don't have the perk right now. Ugh. Here's the strong back perks that I mentioned before. Plus 25 to carry weight. Where is the rifle one? There it is, finally. Okay. We will go ahead and grab that. And then the next rank, we can't get until 18, so we're maxed out on our rifle damage for now. Very, very cool. And ignores 15% of a target's armor. I like that. Okay, this has turned out to be a very productive room, guys, but also a very time-wasting room. Let's get back to the...
Oh boy, that's a lot of metal.
Yeah, it is. Does that impress you? All that metal? Let's get back to the objective at hand here, if we can. I don't know where Dance went. What the hell is this? Oh, it's the smoldering remains of a synth that I shot.
Remain vigilant. We've got turrets ahead.
Hey, thanks for the heads up. Ooh, Tesla science. Energy weapons permanently inflict plus 5% critical damage. Fucking yes! What a great find. I stole his kill. Alright, Dance, you just keep doing that. I'm gonna check out this terminal. Oh, wow. Mars shot project notes. After 6 months, the United States Space Administration finally approved ArcJet as a contractor for the Mars shot project's propulsion and communication systems. Having my team start working on the XMB booster before we secured the contract was a gamble, but it looks like it's going to pay off big. We have a lot of details to hash out with the agency, and we have a lot of work ahead of us, but I think this contract will finally put ArcJet on the map. I was fortunate to be able to add Dr. Rory McClellan to the XMB booster team today. There are a few people who can match Dr. McClellan's aptitude with nuclear propulsion systems, so this truly was a coup. It cost the company a heck of a lot of money to hire him away from his military contracting job, but I'm sure it will be well worth every dollar. We promised the USSA that the booster would be ready at least a year before their July 2078 launch date. With Dr. McClellan at the helm, we should be able to meet that deadline with time to spare. So that was after the bombs dropped, right? So they probably got a lot of work done on it, but never finished it. As the holiday season approaches, it's time to take a step back and look at everything that's happened to ArcJet Systems this year. 5 months ago, my company was struggling to make ends meet. Now with the XMB booster and the deep-range transmitter projects in full swing, ArcJet appears to have received a second chance. Thanks to Dr. McClellan, we're on schedule and under budget. The USSA is thrilled with our progress and is already talking to me about future contracts after we deliver. I don't think it's possible to be ending the year on a better note. You're probably right about that. Dr. McClellan's informed me that we have a problem with the XMB booster. The USSA is demanding that the engine can't exceed their strict weight allowance. I know what that's like, but thanks to the uranium refinement subsystem, we're a few hundred tons over. We're now 1 month behind schedule, and I'm frankly starting to panic. Dr. McClellan assures me he'll find a solution soon, but that isn't helping me get to sleep at night. Alright. USSA has started their public relations campaign for the Mars Shot project, and ArcJet Systems is finding itself caught right in the middle. Now, last week, I think I fielded 15 separate interviews with everyone asking the same questions over and over again. They all want to know when we're delivering the X&B booster so they can take their pretty pictures of the USSA test firing it for the first time. And all I can do is keep smiling and lying through my teeth that the X&B will be delivered when it's ready. I hope Dr. McClellan solves our weight problem soon, or we're never going to get a contract from the USSA ever again. These guys sound like they're in some trouble. I can't believe it, but Dr. McClellan's team finally solved the X&B's weight problem. Now all we need to do is finish tightening a few screws and hoist the thing up into the engine core. If we're lucky, we'll be able to test fire the booster right after the new year. It's funny how things seem so bleak and chaotic during the year, but it all comes together for us just in time for the holidays. It's the most magical time of the year. We've scheduled a photo opportunity tomorrow for the X&B booster's first test firing in the engine core. We're going to stick them all down in the control room and let them shoot their pictures through the thermoglass window after Dr. McClellan gives them a short explanation of how the booster works. The engine puts out a hell of a lot of thrust, so it should be quite a spectacular show. And also, everyone's probably going to die because we forgot to carry a decimal somewhere. The blast is going to be a lot bigger than we thought. It's been 2 weeks since the accident before the X&B's boost... 2 weeks since the accident before the X&B booster's test firing event. Somehow, a photographer managed to wander past security and into the engine core a few hours early. It's the wrong version of past. Dr. McClellan was running a quick test on the booster, letting it run for only a few seconds to make sure it was ready for the demonstration, and burned the photographer into ash. I knew that was going to happen. Wasn't the reason I said, but I knew that was going to happen. Thank God no one else saw what happened. I'm having Brent take care of the remains. After all, that's why I hired him. If word of this accident goes public, we'll be shut down. I might as well put a for sale sign out front. Ooh, little cover-up. Dead reporter. Can't tell anybody. All of the unrest overseas is making the USSA nervous about proceeding with the Mars Shot project. They're telling me they have to delay a year or more depending on what happens. If that's true, we'll just have to make do with the proceeds from the deep-range transmitter contract, which we've already completed. I'm trying to keep everyone's spirits up around here, but it's getting harder and harder with the world falling apart around us. Hopefully our government will work things out and we can all get back to work. That is not what's going to happen. That was an interesting little story. So, I guess that means that the X&B booster is still here. I don't know if anybody would ever have any use for it. So, I just got credit for providing cover for Dance while I was looking at the terminal. That's really funny. Because that is absolutely not what I was doing. But of course, I'll take credit for it, because why not? Okay, so much stuff to loot. Damn. It's like an old-fashioned server room. Can I loot this poster? I want to hang that up in my house. But I'm not allowed to. And there is literally nothing in this room. Okay. This place has a lot of rooms just, like, off to the side. Don't really have anything in them. Well, what was that? Overdue book? What the fuck? It was labeled as a quest. I guess it's a quest item for something. It's really weird. I didn't get any kind of, like, notification or... Like, it didn't pop an active quest? Left and right hand bones? What the fuck? That's really, really weird.
Most folks are just looking for a hand. All we gotta do is offer.
Yes, I know, Piper. You're an idealist. And on some level, I even respect that. But only a little bit. Ooh, hold on a second. Secret area back here? Whoa! What is this? Get in there. Alright, mentats. Those are kind of rare. I think I found a back door down into this area. don't really know what the point of that was. That's cool.
Engine course ahead. Should be our final stop.
Okay, good. Because exploring this place is kind of annoying, if I'm being honest. I got a quick save too, because there's probably going to be all kinds of enemies in here.
Watch your footing. Looks like the power's out in this section.
Thanks for the heads up.
The transmitter should be in the control room at the top of the core, but it looks like the elevators are dead. We'll have to keep heading down for now and find a way to get the facility's power back online. Look at this place. It describes it as a field day in here. There has to be a power backup system somewhere. Scout the maintenance area off the main chamber.
Oh!
Remain here. Watch our backs.
I think Piper just fell from all the way up there. Pipes, you gotta be careful. You're not in power armor like I am. You're gonna break your ankle doing that type of shit. Alright, there's the elevator door. Come on, let's look down here. Junk jet.
Hell yeah.
What the fuck is this? What the f- Is this... Okay, it's obviously some kind of weapon. It has mods on it. It fires junk? Press X to load items into the junk jet. Dude, does this... Is this like the gravity gun from Half-Life? Does it let me... shoot things? Like all my junk that I'm carrying that I don't have a ton of use for? Okay, it said hold X. No, that puts it away. Press X. Oh my god, are you kidding me? So I just take junk and just put it in here. All this shit that I'm carrying. Wait. I accidentally put my chessboard in there. I actually want to keep that. Alright, we'll use that for now.
What's that for?
Alright. Hold right trigger to charge your shot. Fully charged shots do maximum damage. Okay, here goes. Wow. Wow! That is so cool. Hey, and a hard hat. Might come in handy.
Jeering, leering, laughing, mocking, taunting.
Oh, he graduated all right from high school. It's fine, I'm sure he took shop class. Oh look, he's reading the science mags, how cute.
Ha ha ha. Shop class, let's see them make this in shop class. My marvel of engineering. The finest in weaponized refuse acceleration. My beauty. My junk jet. They'll see.
Sweet.
Engineers with their suits and things.
Okay, so this thing was made by a psychopath. Wow. Okay, so we've got a button here. We've got an engine start button. I'm not sure that I want to press that, at least just yet. The waypoint's leading us here to the facilities terminal. And then here we've got... Ooh, is that another core? Fuck yeah. That's mine. My fusion core. Thank you. Save that. Alright, what's on here? Password required. Okay. Wish me luck, guys. Everything I fucking pick is always one likeness. 4. Negative. So that tells me that the O in most is not the one that matched. Loot? No. So T is the last letter. Can I, remove a dud? Oh my god. This is such a pain in the ass. I wish Nick was here so I could just make him do this for me. That would be so much better. I can't even find a string that would remove a dud. Fuck it. Let's just try Rome, I guess. Yeah, I figured that wasn't gonna work. Sorry guys, I don't know why I'm so bad at hacking things. Can I shoot a broom out of the junk jet? Because that sounds amazing. Alright, come on. Let's do this. Let's do it right. Wins. No likeness. Ever. One likeness. No. No. Star.
Nice.
Thank you, Jesus. Okay, main power's off, generators are off. The engine core is operating on emergency power. To conserve energy, all non-critical systems and operations have been suspended. Power options. Start auxiliary generators. Do I want to do this? I think I do. Yeah. Okay.
Engine core power restored.
Oh, there's some shit going on out here.
Primed and standing by for your command.
If I start the engine.
Accepted. Commencing 5-second countdown.
Dude, get out of there. I started the engine. Dude. Dude, get out. Oh my god. Can I yell at him? Dude, did he survive that?
Firing completed with an efficiency rating of 96.7%.
Let's just close the door. I was really hoping that there wasn't some like optional way there to like save him that I just didn't know how to do. I didn't mean to fuck this guy over. Oh god, are you okay?
Oh my god, are you all right? Cooked by those flames. But thanks to my power armor, I'm still in one piece. The important thing is that we're still alive. We have a way to get to the transmitter. Let's go.
Dude, he ain't even mad. That's kind of amazing. So, it said that those were optional activities there. I wonder if I could have just came out and just... Excited automatic, eh. Wonder if I could have just came out and just went toe-to-toe with all these guys. That would have been pretty cool. But I think my way was actually cooler. It would have really sucked if he died, though. I'm sure the Brotherhood would have just never accepted me if that had happened. Screw you guys, get your own elevator. This one's only for me. Bring it, man. Ah, okay. It's hard to tell if I'm doing a lot of damage or not. Hard to aim precisely with this thing, too. That sent him flying.
Hope that's the last of them. Damn it. I don't see the device anywhere.
Pan out and check the Sith remains. They may have been after the transmitter as well.
Yeah, I found it over here. But I'm gonna loot before I take it. So it seemed like this thing did fairly decent damage, but it was hard to tell in the heat of combat with everybody else popping off shots at him too. I will say though that the rate of fire is not great. I think maybe if we could like upgrade this thing, it would be a lot better.
And over here we have a rare mint condition. Just what the heck do you think this stuff did?
I think it assisted them in the building of many things. Begin test fire. Do we want to do that? Damn. The mother load there. We should probably save that test fire in case a whole bunch more of those things show up out there. Alright, let's grab it. Really? Just like that? Alright, well hold on. Now I want to see the test fire. Fuel reserves is 0.5%. Aww. No test fire for us. Sorry, guys. Now, I'll tell you what though, power armor sure is a game changer in this. I mean, I haven't had to use a single stim pack or any kind of healing items in here. Which is pretty great. And I feel like I've barely used any of my fusion cores at all. Hold on, I see things here that I want. I will say, the best thing about the junk jet gun is that it gives you a reason, like an even better reason to pick up all this shit. Because I know that, like, a lot of it's used in crafting and settlement stuff, but I feel like a lot of it you also wouldn't end up ever using in the long run. Alright, are we good? We done here?
Paladin Dance.
Well, that could have gone smoother, but mission accomplished.
We'll try and persuade him. He's kind of a hard ass, but we'll try.
Smoother? I thought we did fine.
We're both alive and the transmitter's been secured.
Fuck you.
No need to scrutinize the details.
I thought we worked well as a team too, for the most part.
I thought we worked well as a team.
Agreed. It's a refreshing change to work with a civilian who can follow orders properly. That being said, I believe we have two important matters to discuss. First and foremost, if you'll hand me the deep-range transmitter, I'd like to compensate you for your assistance during this operation. I think you'll find this weapon useful. It's my own personal modification of the standard Brotherhood laser rifle. May it serve you well in battle.
Okay. Righteous Authority. Critical shots do double damage and the critical meter fills 15% faster. Sweet deal. It'd probably be really fun to be a dick here, but I don't want to make an enemy out of these guys. So we'll just say thank you.
Thank you. You're welcome, civilian. Now, as far as the second matter goes, I wanted to make you a proposal. We had a lot thrown at us back there. Our op could have ended in disaster, but you kept your cool and handled it like a soldier. There's no doubt in my mind that you've got what it takes. The way I see it, got a choice. You could spend the rest of your life wandering from place to place, trading an extra hand for a meager reward. Or you could join the Brotherhood of Steel and make your mark on the world. So, what do you say?
Brother, you don't even have to ask.
I'd be honored to join.
Yeah, is honored the word?
What?
That's what I wanted to hear. Meet me back at the police station and we'll discuss the details.
Piper, is this going to be a thing going forward? Are you really going to bust my balls over this? Because this is my job, okay? This is how I put food on the table. Well, kind of. Actually, I've been doing that just fine by going out and looting, but Alright, well that's it for that quest. Return to Cambridge and we can do some more Brotherhood stuff, I guess. Which, is probably the route we're gonna go when we come back. Probably just gonna fast travel there, because I don't want to waste a ton of Fusion Core power walking back. This has been awesome, guys. I really enjoyed this quest. I enjoy using the power armor. And I feel like we're finally making some good progress and getting a handle on things. So, thank you for the support on this series, guys. You guys are awesome. I appreciate all the likes and comments. Even though I know that my gameplay isn't always the best, and we've had some rough patches here and there, everyone's still really nice in the comments, and that's really cool. It means a lot to me. So thank you. I'm Dude Long Couch, and I'll catch you guys in the next part. See ya.